In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to take any image. In this case, we're going to be using this one right here, and we're going to take it and turn it into a photorealistic 3D scene. So we're going from photo to something with depth. And the technique we're going to be using is very popular. It's called camera mapping. Some people call it projection mapping. And the basic idea is we need two things. We need a camera that pretty much matches the camera this photo is taken with, so the perspective and the views lined up. And the second thing is we need the geometry of the scene. So in this case, we need a floor plane, we need three walls, and we also need a ceiling. So in this case, it's super easy because it's just a giant box. So we need our camera and our box. And the first thing we do is we do the camera alignment. And you can do this in Blender right away. However, it's very difficult to tweak and get it to look like it was taken from the correct angle. So the best way to do it is there is a free program. The link will be in the description. It's called FSPI or FSPI. I really don't know how to pronounce it. So you download this free program and also a free add-on for Blender so you can import the files from FSPI, which is what I'm going to call it from now on. So once you download it, link in the description, we're going to open it here. And then what we need to do is bring this photo into FSPI. I really hope that's right. What we do is we take the ceiling photo, we bring it in. Okay, so here is our interface. First thing you might notice is that everything may or may not look super dark. If it does, just go to dim image and disable this so we can actually see what we're doing. And then the idea is we're going to take these lines, red being the x-axis, green being the y-axis, and then blue, which we can enable down here, being the z-axis. We're going to take these and we're going to line them up to our photo, and then the software is actually going to know where the camera should be. Okay, so let's start off with our x-axis, and I want this to be horizontal across the photo. So we're going to take one of these, and we're just going to line it up against this wall, so something like this. And then we want to fine-tune it. So you're going to take this and hold Shift, and that's going to let us zoom in. And make sure that you do this as accurately as possible, because the quality of our camera is going to be determined by how accurately we do this. So here we have one of our red lines. And to do the other, we need to make sure that it's parallel to this x-axis. So we can actually put it up here or along the carpet, which is what I'm going to go for. So we're going to put one here, again holding Shift, and then the other somewhat over here. Need to make sure that's aligned. Okay, so once you're happy with this, you want to move on to the other axis. In this case, the y-axis, and that's going to be perpendicular going along here. So we're just going to bring this over to the wall, just like that. And then the obvious other option is going to be the other wall. So this scene is very, very simple. Other scenes might have, you might have a bit harder time actually finding what you should be using for your lines. But generally, every scene will have something. Okay, so once you're happy with this, we actually want to see the quality of what we did. So go to 3D Guide and change it from off into XY grid floor. If you didn't use X and Y, used X and Z, then go to XZ. So we used X and Y. So we're going to enable this. We're going to bring this dot down here. And you may or may not see anything. If you don't, that means that there's a vanishing point error, as you can see right here. And that basically means you need to do a bit more tweaking, like we're doing. And you see this ground plane is popping on and off. I think this line is the issue. Yeah, there we go. And since this is so sensitive to where we put this, basically that means that we should pick a different spot because this isn't very accurate. So I'm just going to pick this line over here because it's easier to see. Something like that. Okay, make sure our y-axis is well defined. And again, make sure you do this as accurately as possible. Okay, let's adjust this line over here. Move that all the way down here. And then you see that we're getting a floor plane that's lining up pretty well. And you can put this wherever you want. I'm going to put it about here. And again, you can do a lot more tweaking. You can actually find out the focal length of your camera from this picture. You just enable this, but you need to know what camera you're using. In this case, I actually don't know what camera was used for this photo, so I'm just going to ignore that. But then once you have your ground plane, and again, you might have to tweak with it if your vanishing point has a calculation error. Once you're happy with this, go to File, Save As, and then we're just going to name it, in this case, Camera Map. And then you're actually done with FSPI, So you can close that and open up Blender, where we're going to import everything. So again, make sure you have the free add-on. You can make sure it's enabled by going to Edit, Preferences, Add-ons, and then just typing in FSPI. In this case, I actually already have it imported and enabled. So make sure that's the case. So we're going to take everything, A, and we're going to delete it with X. And then we're going to go to File, Import, and you're going to see that we have a FSPI option when you have the add-on. And then just find our camera map. And you see it's already imported everything. And basically all this is it's a camera with a background image. So if you go to your camera settings and go to background images, you can actually edit this. You can make it less transparent like that, which is what we're going to do. And then what we're also going to do is shift A to add a plane, just like that. And you see it's already matching. This plane looks like it's flush with the floor. Okay, so that's good. Also, something you might notice is that everything is upside down. As you can see, if that's the case, what you can do is I'm just going to select all my objects, rotate it along the y-axis by 180 degrees, but then something we also need to do is bring this up. And you can also do some stuff with the 3D cursor to do this, but this is much faster. Okay, I think I'm happy with this. Yes, everything still matches. So now what we need to do is, now that our camera is matched up, the next step is reconstructing our scene using geometry. So we're going to take our plane, we're going to go into edit mode, and then we're just going to drag these edges so they go along the floor. So we're going to go 2 for edge mode, and then we can actually zoom in, and then G, X, and just bring that there. And this should be pretty accurate. Like, when we bring our edge, it should line up. And that depends on the accuracy of what you did, but we did a pretty good job. We're going to bring this back. And then we're going to take this and bring it forwards. Okay, once we're happy with that and we have our floor plane, I'm going to select this edge, and this edge. Click E to extrude and then right click to move it back to where it was. And then G, Z to bring it up. And that should be lining up pretty well. You can see there's a bit of error here, but we can always fix that later. Make sure you line this up to the best of your ability. Okay, so this is pretty good. We're going to select two edges, this one and this one, and click F to fill in our ceiling. And then the last thing we need to do is select this edge, let's actually exit out of camera, this one, and then just bring them back a bit. Okay, so we have reconstructed our scene, pretty easy. So now let's actually project our textures onto here. So I'm going to go into object mode, go to shading, I'm going to make a new material, and we don't actually need any principled BSDF or any shaders at all, really. We're just going to import a raw image into the surface here. But you can also add shading if you want. So Shift A, go to Texture, Image Texture, and plug this in here. And then all we have to do is put in our photo inside this image texture. So navigate and find that. There we go. And you see that everything is looking really messed up. But what we need to do is project this texture from the perspective of this camera. And there's a couple ways to do that, but my favorite way is as follows. So let me go into Rendered View. So select your geometry. I'm just going to call this, I'll call it room. So select your room object. And then what we're going to do is go to modifiers. And then we're going to add a UV project, which is exactly what we want. So we need to click a couple things. First of all, we need a UV map. I'm just going to use the default one. We need our projector, where it's going to project from, and that's being this camera. So select your camera. And you already see it's looking a lot better, still really distorted, but a lot better. First thing we need to do is this aspect right here. This is assuming it's a 1x1 image, which it's not. It's not like 100x100 or 1500x1500. We actually need to calculate this aspect, but that's super easy. We're going to go to our photo and go to the properties. And you see here it's 3264x2448. I'm just going to open up a calculator. And all you do is divide these two numbers. So 3264 divided by 2448. So our aspect ratio is 1.3 repeated. So we're just going to type in here 1. Let's do 4 threes. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so already looking better, but still some heavy distortion. And basically the trick here is our UV project modifier depends on how much geometry we have. So here we only have, let's see, we only have 5 faces. So to get this to be more accurate, we need to add more geometry without changing the shape of this. So that basically means we need to subdivide. So we're going to add a modifier, add a subsurf, and we're just going to bring this up. But you see it's actually changing the shape. But this looks kind of cool, actually. But if you don't want this, just change this to simple mode, like that. And then you can bring this up, and you see the distortions going down. Let me just bring this back down so you can see. This is original, and then bring that up. There we go. And you want to make sure that your modifier stacks in the right order. Moving this up is not going to give the same results as down. And in this case, we actually want it up, I believe. Yes, and you see that it's looking distorted from this view, but that's actually what is going on. So here's what we got. We can go to camera, and everything lines up perfectly. And now to actually see the results of what we've made, let's take this camera and put another camera inside of here, so not from the projector. So Shift-D to duplicate, right-click to put it back, and then G-Y to bring this in. Okay, so this is our new camera. We're going to call this the viewing camera. So this is viewing. And then you just want to, when you go into camera mode, it's going to go to the same camera. If you want to switch it, go to view, cameras, set active object. When you have this selected, you go to view, camera, set active object as camera. And now we have this like that. Let's go back into that. And we can go to, we can hit N to open some settings and actually rotate around our 3D scene. So this is actually truly 3D now, which is pretty cool. We can go into Cycles Render and do some trippy things, which I think is a good idea. Okay, so we are in Cycles, and I think something interesting to do is to add a giant mirror in the middle of this. So we're gonna go Shift-A, Mesh, Plane, make that big, and have it kind of cut through our surface here. So you can see now we have a true 3D scene that other objects can cut through and interact with. In this one, we're going to go to shading, and we're going to add a new material, principled BSDF, and just make it this metallic, low roughness kind of mirror surface. Okay, perfect, and then go back into rendered. Let's go to layout. Okay, go to camera view, and you see now we have this giant mirror in our scene, and we can rotate it. Whoops, I am not rotating the right thing. Make sure you have the right object selected, and we can rotate our giant mirror and do a lot of cool effects like this. Rotate it along this axis, like that. So, I don't know, you could do a whole bunch of stuff with this, but this is just a video about camera mapping, so let's close this out. So this is, again, a simple example because we just made a cube. In other cases, we have stairs, we have trees, and a lot of that will require cylinders and a bunch of harder geometry. But this is the most simple case. I think I'm also going to make a video about the harder case, but either way, I hope you learned something. Thank you for watching. Make sure to use subsurf after you put UV project. Either way, thanks for watching. Bye, guys.